Chitkul village is literally the last inhabited village in India on the Indo-Tibetan border. And at 11,320 feet above sea level, the vistas are jaw-dropping. Nestling lazily on the banks of the Baspa River in Kinnaur district of Himachal Pradesh, Chitkul is a postcard come to life. Framed by the Himalayas and set into a valley is a smattering of quaint wooden homes of the 650 people that live here. Locals believe that the resident deity of the village, Mathi Devi, decided to make this remote village her home after a long trek from Vrindavan city, after which the region began to prosper. The layout of Chitkul is typical of the region, with narrow, steep and meandering footpaths connecting each household with public places. Chitkul fort towers over the village. Although popularly referred to as a killa or fort, it is actually a shrine. A three-story tower-like structure, it is built in the typical Pahari style of architecture. There is a small shrine on the topmost story, which is surrounded by wooden balconies on all four sides. Another prominent site is the main temple of Mathi Devi, which locals say is around 500 years old. The Mathi Devi temple is an architectural gem. Recently restored, the older wooden roofs have been replaced by stone. As with the fort, this temple too is a combination of wood and stone and is a perfect example of the unique Kinnauri Pahari style of architecture. Set in the middle of the village, the temple has intricate wooden carvings and a distinctive roof profile. In fact, this unique architectural style can be seen in every house of this quaint little village. Construction materials vary, as does the basic house form. Interestingly, no two homes in Chitkul are the same in size and detail, even though they are close together. Originally, roofs were covered by wood, which was replaced by local stone and now tin sheets. Travelling to Chitkul is a daredevil act, as you have to pass through one of the most dangerous mountain roads in Kinnaur district. In fact, all roads leading to Chitkul are closed from November to March due to excessive snowfall. Many who make it this far are drawn by the quietude and natural beauty of the place. So before things change too much, escape to this land of the gods on the very edge of India. You can't get further away than this.